Hello. In this video, I'm going to talk about sound intensity and the decibel scale, which is the way we measure sound loudness. Firstly, sound intensity. The word intensity means power of something divided by an area. So it's how much power passes through a unit area. And so it has the units watts per meter squared. If you imagine sound travels to hit a window, if we know the area of the window, and the power of the sound that passes through that window, we could work out the intensity of that sound by dividing the power by the area. So intensity is a measure of loudness for us. Our ears pick up intensity and measure that rather than measuring the power. Can't directly measure the power. Turns out intensity is proportional to loudness in some way. Just like ripples in a pond spread out and lose amplitude, so too do waves passing out for sound. So the waves that spread out from this sound spread out in three dimensions. And if we were to go a certain distance away, you'd get an area over which that sound was spread out. If you double the distance, what's going to happen to that area? Did you realize that the area is going to be four times greater? So twice the distance will have four times the area, and three times the distance would therefore have nine times the area. So the area that spreads out is proportional to the distance squared. In fact, that's not quite the correct picture, because the sound spreads out over the surface area of a sphere, so we have these slightly curved shapes that it spreads out over. And the surface area of a sphere is given by the formula 4 pi r squared. So if we take our intensity formula, power over area, and know that the power of the sound is spreading out over the surface area of a sphere, we can say that the intensity of a sound is the power of the instrument that produced it divided by 4 pi r squared. So here's an example. If a drum emits 0.1 of watt of power, sound intensity at a distance of 3 meters away would be given by this formula. So power divided by area, which is 8.8 times 10 to the minus 4 watts per meter squared. Now, if we know the intensity at one point given by the given by a sound, then we could also write a formula for the intensity at another point given by a sound. Doesn't matter what these two radiuses are. We can divide one formula by the other, and this would simplify down. So don't forget, if I divide by a fraction, that's the same as multiplying by the inverse of that fraction. You can see that P cancels. It's the same source emitting the power, and 4 pi cancels. And so you end up with this ratio formula. The ratio of intensities is inversely proportional to the distances squared. Just put that into an example for you, because we can use this formula to work out how loud a sound would be in a different location without working back and working out the original power of the sound. This is how you do it. So the drum has a sound intensity of this value, and it's 4 meters away. What would the intensity be 12 meters away? Well, it's obviously going to be lower because it's further away, but it's not 12 over 4 times lower. It's 12 squared over 4 squared times lower. So take this intensity formula, I1 over I2 is R2 over R1 all squared, and rearrange to give the new intensity I2, which will be I1 times R1 over R2 squared. Don't forget to square them. So I2 would be this original intensity times 4 squared over 12 squared, which gives this value 6.6 times 10 to the minus 7 watts per meter squared. Now, our ear is amazingly sensitive to a range of different intensities. The threshold of hearing, you can't hear much below about 1 times 10 to the minus 12 watts per meter squared. But you can hear sounds up to about a watt per meter squared. In fact, you can hear sounds louder than that, but they become quite painful. Now, this scale is vast. It's a huge difference between 1 and a millionth of a watt per meter squared. So the decibel scale is a simpler way of enabling us to cope with sound loudnesses that we can hear. And each 10 decibels represents a change of 10 times the intensity. So 10 to the minus 11 is 10 times bigger than 10 to the minus 12, and the decibel has gone up by 10 decibels. So 10 decibels represents 10 times more intense sound. The formula for decibel is this. The sound intensity level, so it's given the symbol L, in decibels, is 10 multiplied by log, and that's log to the base 10, of the intensity of the sound divided by I0. You have to have a ratio for intensity levels, so it's how many times larger the sound level is that you're measuring, the intensity, over some reference intensity. And the reference intensity is normally the threshold of human hearing. So the quietest sound that you can hear. So we work out how many decibels louder the sound that you're listening to is than the sound that you could only just hear. So for example, a girl hears a drum with a sound intensity of 6 times 10 to the minus 6. What level does this correspond to in decibels? So applying the formula, we've got 10 log 6 times 10 to the minus 6 over 1 times 10 to the minus 12. Evaluate that number, take the log to base 10 and multiply by 10, and you get 68 decibels. And of course, that really means 68 decibels louder than the quietest sound she could hear. Now, if you know a bit about logarithms, you'll know that 10 cubed is 1,000 and log of 1,000 is 3. In other words, the log is the inverse function of raising something to the power, raising 10 to that number, to that power. So to summarize, log of 10 to the power x is equal to x. So you'd need to know this if you had a problem that asked you to solve things this way round, to work out a new intensity given a decibel change. So if you hear a drum of this intensity and her friend is sitting closer to that drum and hears the sound 8 decibels louder, what's the intensity of sound that her friend hears? So we can use this formula, and instead of the reference intensity being I0, the threshold of human hearing, we could just say the change in level is 10 log I2 over I1, and look at two different intensities. If we divide both sides by 10, we get this. And then if we take the inverse of the log function, that's raising something to the power of 10, we get this. 10 to the power of this lot is equal to I2 over I1. So we can use that formula to work out the new intensity, or the intensity that her friend would hear if she was hearing a sound 8 decibels louder. So you'd say the original intensity multiplied by so that's this, multiplied by 10 to the power 8 over 10, which comes out to be 3.79 times 10 to the minus 5 watts per meter squared. The human ear is sensitive to a whole range of different frequencies, from about 20 hertz to about 20 kilohertz. But at different intensity levels, you can hear of different frequencies. So you need to have quite a loud sound, about 90 to 100 decibels at 20 hertz to be able to hear it properly. But sounds of about 4 or 5 kilohertz, you can hear right down very, very quiet sounds in that frequency range. And speech lies well within, tends to lie well within this sort of, this kind of band, between about 100 and maybe you get a few frequencies up to the thousands of hertz. And tends to be between sort of 40 and 60 decibels. So in summary, you've seen that intensity is power divided by area. And that applies to all sorts of areas of physics, particularly here for sound. Sound intensity is measured in watts per meter squared. And you can use a ratio formula to determine two different intensities at two different distances. The sound intensity level in decibels, the level is given by 10 log I over I naught, where I naught is usually a reference frequency, the quietest sound you can hear. You can also have a change in level given by 10 log of one intensity divided by another. And finally, you can use some logarithmic maths to determine that a ratio of two intensities is 10 to the power of the difference in level in decibels divided by 10. Hope that helps.